In this episode, we're going to be identifying the attributes of our PC case.
You're watching ITProTV.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in to more of the hands-on PC build. That's right, the time has come where we're going to explore the PC case. That's right, we're going to be identifying some of the attributes of your case. So if you haven't seen one or maybe you haven't worked in one, you'll be aware of just some of the general attributes of a PC case. Now, keep in mind that every case is slightly different. One of the things that is consistent across the board is when you pick out a form factor, like we have an ATX motherboard with an ATX power supply and an ATX case. So there are certain things that are going to be the same across all of the cases, but some of the bells and whistles might differ slightly. So for instance, one of the very first things here at the bench here, we've got the top of our case. That does kind of differ from PC to PC. You'll see here that we've got a couple of our USB 3.0 ports here. We've got a couple of our audio ports, one for the microphone, one for the speakers, right? So your microphone here or speakers / headset. We've also got an RGB light control, kind of neat on this one. It does have some LED lights in it. And then ultimately we have our power button here that we'll be connecting later on when we get our motherboard installed. This is kind of cool. This is a dust filter and a area to install a 120 millimeter fan should we want to increase the amount of circulation in the case if we feel we need it. Little dust cover and it's got some magnets on it, which is really handy. And drop it in place and we are good to go. So that's the top of the case. Let's go ahead and I'm gonna turn this case around and kind of face you with this. This is the front on view of the case. And there's actually a case cover here. And if we pull down here, just very easy, not too hard on the bottom, you're gonna see that we can actually remove the front cover. And I'm just gonna set this to the side for a second so we can just kind of talk about what we have right here. Now, what you'll see are two hollow areas, one here and one here. These are actually two spaces for additional 120 millimeter fans. If we, again, want to increase the cooling system, remember, if you're going to go with a higher performance type processor, graphics card, both, if you will, you're probably going to want to increase the air circulation inside of the case. So this case does allow you to do that. A couple other things that we'll see down here. If I go ahead and take this off, this is actually the accessory box here, and it's a little quick release rails. Normally, there would be a hard drive in here, and we could release the hard drive just as easy. So this is a little accessory box in here. There's a motherboard standoff and some motherboard screws, which we're going to be using in upcoming episodes. When we decide to, it's time to drop the motherboard in and get that installed. We've got another quick release. This is just a 3-point-inch drive rail, quick release. Remember, one of the things that I told you is that you really today don't need a lot of tools. In the earlier days, you'd have to have a torque set and you'd have to actually screw these hard drives in. Today, they make it really easy to get these in and out. So we'll just set these to the side. And then you can see down here, this hollow area, this is actually where we're going to mount our 500 watt power supply when we install our power supply. So a lot of cool things here. Let's go ahead and I'm going to turn the case back around and we're going to take off the side panel here, and these are just some quick thread screws that I'm grabbing. Again, this is kind of toolless. If you first get your case, you might see, because they do take a Phillips screwdriver, and they might be tightened down pretty darn tight for the first time you take your case off. So I'm just going to unthread these real quick, and what we'll do is we'll take this side panel off, and we'll just kind of put that to the side for now here too. And what you can see is that we've got a series of cables. We've got different cables in here. We've got our audio cables here. We've got cables for our USB 3.0. You can see the blue here. There's a SATA cable here too. And that SATA cable, believe it or not, it's not going to the hard drive like we would think. This actually powers the LEDs, those red, green, blue LEDs that we were talking about. And then other things that we have in here, again, some additional fans, connections, if you will. And then there's a slew of front panel headers that we're going to be looking at coming up in a later episode. And these front panel headers kind of look like a bunch of little clips, if you will. Nothing really crazy here. Here's one of them. This actually is the hard drive LED light indicator. And there's a handful of those in here that we'll be looking at. And we'll have an episode because that's a really important part of your setup, is making sure that the top of the the case, those buttons that we were looking at, we want to make sure that they're inserted correctly. There's a power switch right there. So lots of space in this case as well, too. You can see right here, this is actually a 2.5-inch to 3.5-inch sled adapter. We're going to use that when we install our SSD, because our SSD is a 2.5-inch form factor, and these drive rails, they actually take a 3.5-inch form factor, so we can actually attach, and that's really nice about this case, that it comes with that, and we don't have to purchase an adapter after the fact, and then it allows us to basically install our solid-state drive without having to purchase additional components. You can see the backside of where the motherboard is. We've installed our heat sink. Remember the back plate that we installed to get the heat sink installed, it's going to actually sit right here, and then if we kind of just turn this around, let me put these cables back, we'll just take a look real quick at the back of the case. Back of the case, pretty straightforward here, nothing really crazy here. We've got a 120 millimeter fan that came with it. This is where our back panel is going to sit when we install our motherboard. Your motherboard actually sits on the side wall of the case, and plenty of room for expansion should we need to, should we have that on our motherboard capabilities later if we want to add, for instance, a dedicated graphics card, maybe we want to add two graphics cards, again, if your motherboard supports it, and then some various other graphic or adapter cards. Like, for instance, if I wanted to install a wireless adapter, maybe I wanted wireless connectivity with this this device here, or PC, we could do that as well. So, a lot of cool things going on here, and I definitely like to see the added expandability that we could have. And if we look at the bottom of the case too, you'll see that there's actually a dust cover here. You can probably hear it rattling around here. And that's really good because our power supply is going to sit on the bottom, and that fan is going to help assist the cooling. But this dust cover, again, kind of like the top dust cover, allows us the ability to make sure that we kind of have a cleaner air, not so much dust and debris entering the case. So a lot of good features on this. Last but not least, you'll see here that we've got some tempered glass, and if you can see this little bit of ripple across the top, that's because the tempered glass has a protective coating, a little sticker on it, cellophane, if you will, and we're just going to leave that on during our build because we don't want to scratch our case. Now, when we install our motherboard, we're going to install it here, and you can see these little black bolts. There's quite a few of them. They're not actually bolts here. These are what are known as motherboard standoffs. They make sure that the motherboard doesn't ground out to the inside of the case, and this is the ATX form factor, but one of the great things is you'll see a lot of these cases have multiple screw hole positions, because if you have a case, you have an ATX case, but maybe you have a extended ATX motherboard, which is just a little bit bigger than the traditional ATX case. That means this one will allow for it. It'll allow it to fit. So a lot of good options in this case, and again, we're going to be attaching our motherboard in an upcoming episode when we install it to the side of the case. So these are some of the component or some of the attributes of your case. Definitely be aware of them. Check with your vendor documentation. The vendor documentation we have actually came in our little accessory box with some of the other, like the motherboard screws. And then just get familiar with your case prior to actually doing your motherboard installation, your power supply installation, so you can kind of get an idea about how you're going to do the cable routing, how you might go about maybe attaching additional fans. And when you do that, it can make for a very successful PC build.
Thank you for watching IT Pro TV.